Good morning, William Pickett Old Post Road Elementary School. This is Mrs. Clinton, one of your assistant principals. And I am so excited to be bringing you our Power Up Assembly this morning. We know that we have had buildings that have been filled with smiles, penguins, as you have returned to the buildings. So we would like to thank you, Mrs. Bosley, Ms. Scharf, Mr. Stump, and myself, for coming back to school with your positive attitudes and your smiles. The buildings feel better with you back in them. And teachers and staff, we celebrate all of you because this would not be possible without everything that you are doing on a daily basis. So thank you. And along with that, makes you kind of think a little bit about teamwork. Boys and girls, when I mention teamwork, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Maybe you think about playing on a soccer team. Maybe you think about playing on a football team or a dance team. Maybe you even think about teamwork whenever you work together collaboratively in your classrooms. Those would all be right. Teamwork is working together. We will be learning a lot more about teamwork in the month of April. Speaking of teamwork, we have had several staff members who have been a valuable part of our team over the past month to be sure that we have had adults in the classrooms where we need them. So thank you to Ms. Dunmore, Mr. Phillips, Ms. Mullins, Ms. Bartlett, Ms. Anowek, Ms. Bukrowski, Ms. Williams, and Ms. Hawley for all that you did for us in the month of March. We appreciate you and we celebrate you and your flexibility. We would also like to give a shout out this morning to Ms. Alter. April is going to be a month where we celebrate English language learners, and she has a special presentation prepared for you here this morning. So thank you, Ms. Alter, for helping us celebrate ELL month. April also happens to be math month, and Ms. Walker, our Title I math specialist, she has prepared a month-long calendar of activities for you. And penguins, you are going to enjoy them. There are going to be some fun videos, and I don't want to give too much away. And boys and girls, as I finish up my part this morning for our Power Up Assembly, there's a quote by Helen Keller, and it goes, "Alone we can do so little. Together we can do so much." So in April, when we talk more about teamwork, I just want you to try to remember that, what Helen Keller says. It's all of us working together as a team, as a WPOPR team that makes the dream happen. So enjoy everything that we have coming up this morning. And again, thank you for tuning in.
Hey there, boys and girls. It's one of your favorite music teachers here, Mr. Jefferson, here with a warm-up dance for our Power Up Assembly, okay? Now, boys and girls, when we dance, remember, you are copying me. And I want you to pay really close attention because during this dance, you may see some people that you recognize, all right? All right, boys and girls, let's do this. Copy me. Thank you.
Penguins, and welcome to our April Power Up Assembly. Mrs. Cahoe here. This month is all about teamwork, and our team has put together a fantastic Power Up for you. Let's get started with our Penguin news from Miss Ports and Miss Shiflin.
Ready? You got this.
Good job,
Miss Shiflin. Thank you, of course. That's so kind of you to say.
It's curving a little, but we can do it. We can keep going.
We're live.
Good morning, William Pig, Old Post Road families. It's Miss Shiflin here.
And Miss Ports.
Bringing you the Penguin News. This theme for our Good News Assembly is teamwork. What do you know about teamwork, Miss Ports?
Teamwork makes the dream work! Hey!
That's right, Miss Ports. Do you have a favorite sports team?
I really don't. I like all teams. You know?
Not one to favor one over the other.
Not one to favor. I just like the team aspect, the team morale, people cheering each other on, working together as hard as they can.
Kind of like what we did down here. Building our tower.
Exactly.
Of tissues.
During COVID times, you had a lot of tissues, you know?
It was great.
Yeah.
Well, why don't we teach our viewers how to be an awesome teammate?
Sure thing. So here's some tips on how to work as a team. Use encouraging words such as good idea or I like that one. Next thing, contribute ideas. Offer to help by saying, how can we make that work together? Or how can I help you?
Remind others to be positive.
Listen to all ideas offered by others.
Work toward a solution together.
That's what I'm talking about. As always, we interviewed some special penguins to talk about teamwork, this month's theme. So, let's cut to the live feed.
Oh. Hello, William Pinka. It's me, Miss Shiflin, and I'm here with...
Jamari
and...
Brianna.
Hi, friends. Good to see you here today in the newsroom. How we doing?
Good.
All right, well, we know that this month is April, and our theme for this assembly today is teamwork. Jamari, do you have a favorite sports team?
Yes, Ravens.
The Baltimore Ravens. We love the Ravens up in this room, don't we?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. How about you, Miss Brianna?
The Orioles.
The Baltimore Orioles. Well, friends, I'm not sure if you know this, but opening day is this week, so hopefully the Orioles continue this winning streak they've been on. We will see how it goes. Very exciting. Now that we are back in school, most of us are, which is really awesome, really fun, we're going to talk about teamwork in school. Jamari, think about pride. What letter comes to mind when you have to work as a team or show teamwork? What letter do you think of most?
R
for?
Respectful.
Respectful. Jamari, why do you think it is important to be respectful when you're working on a team?
Because if you don't be respectful to your team, then you're not a team.
Oh, if you don't show respect to your team, you are not part of that team. I couldn't agree with you more, sir. Pretty genius. Brianna, what letter comes to mind when you think of teamwork with pride?
Prepared.
Why is it important to be prepared if you are on a team?
Because when you're prepared, you're ready to do anything what your teacher says, and you are ready to do any work you have to do.
You are ready for anything when you are part of a team if you are prepared. Think about it, Brianna. If you were on the Orioles team and you came to a game without a baseball bat, are you prepared?
No.
Could you play in the game?
No.
It would not be easy, would it?
No.
No. Well, thanks for stopping by, friends. It's been great. It's been fun. We'll see you back here in May.
Bye-bye.
Hello, William Pinkle Old Post Road students. I have a very special guest with me today, and his name is?
Kyer Marquise Roan,
and he is in second grade in whose class?
Miss Denning's
class. And as you know, the theme this month is teamwork. Kyer, who's your favorite team?
The Steelers.
Oh no, I think I have to stop the interview right now. Go Ravens, right? Oh my goodness. Okay, well, when we think of teamwork, what makes a good team?
You have to work with people.
You have to work with people? And if you're thinking of the Penguin Pride letters, what Penguin Pride letter would you use on your team?
I will have nice people.
You would be nice to people, so you would be maybe all respectful? Absolutely. Great answers. We got some smart second graders over here. Okay, would you like to say hi to anyone?
Hi, guys. And hi, Shapora. Hi, Olivia. Hi, all the kids that are in my class.
Awesome. Great shout out. Back to you.
All right, everyone. Stay tuned for next month's Good News Assembly. To close out, watch this quick kid president video about teamwork. He really knows how to sell it.
He really does.
Well, I'm Ms. Shiflett.
And I'm Ms. Ports.
We'll see you next month. Have a great weekend.
Okay.
Thank you, Ms. Ports and Ms. Shiflett, and some of our penguins, for teaching us all about teamwork. Next, we have a very special part of our assembly this month. This month is ELL month, and Ms. Alter has some great celebrations of our students. You will hear them throughout our Power Up this morning. Let's hear from Ms. Alter about our celebration.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Mrs. Alter. I'm sure you've seen me coming into your classrooms to visit with some students. I work with students here at William Paca Old Post Road that can speak more than one language. Did you know that we have students in our school from all over the world and students that can speak many different languages? We have students that can speak Spanish, French, African languages, Korean, Chinese. The list goes on and on. I think it's really cool to learn more about different countries and cultures and languages. Today, you're going to meet some of our friends who were born in other countries. They're going to share some information about their country and their culture and a little bit about their language. Have fun as you take a tour around the world.
What's the weather like in Cameroon?
There are no seasons, and sometimes it's hot from time to time, and...
Do they get a lot of rain?
Yeah, we did, sometimes.
So there's sort of like a rainy season and a hot season?
Yeah.
What kind of foods did you eat in Cameroon?
I had conchaf. It's when you mix beans and corn for your vines. And I had fufu and arrow. But here you guys call it arrow spinach. And fufu is still fufu here.
What is fufu?
Fufu is something made with plant and soft something makes fufu. Okay. And also there was Tampico was a drink, and it was super good.
Kind of like a soda that we drink here?
No, it was supposed to be frozen.
What kind of things do people do for fun in Cameroon?
We play soccer, jump rope, and run, and hide and seek in the compound, you know, the backyard.
So a lot of the outside stuff. What was school like in Cameroon?
School was hard.
What languages do they speak in Cameroon?
English and French.
Do you know any words in French?
Yeah, to fait quoi, that means what are you doing there? And also,
was really different in Cameroon that you want to tell people about?
Yeah, Cameroon, it's not bad when you get to know it. It's good. No, it's not bad.
Je pouvais, je le ferais. À tous les autres filles, hasta la vista. I'm not a player.
Alejandra, where are you from?
Honduras.
Tell me about Honduras. What's the weather like there?
Hot.
All year long?
Yes.
Do you get
rainy?
And some rain. Do you get the different seasons like summer and winter and spring?
No.
Snow?
No.
No snow. So I could wear a t-shirt and shorts all the time?
Yes.
What language do you speak?
Espanol.
Espanol or Spanish? So, can you tell me some colors in Spanish?
Amarillo, rosado, rojo, azul, morado, negro.
Amarillo is?
Yellow.
Azul?
Is blue.
What color is red?
Red is rojo.
What about yellow?
It's amarillo.
Orange?
It's anaranjado.
And green?
Verde.
What kind of foods did you eat in Honduras? Can you get those same foods here in the United States?
I don't think so.
Only maybe if your mom makes it for you?
Yes.
What do people do for fun in Honduras? What do kids
we
do?
We go to the pool and we ride bikes and go to a park.
Kind of the same things as here, right?
Yes.
Thank you to Mrs. Alter, Johannes, and Alejandra for that great celebration. We'll have more celebrations coming up, but first, let's play a game. This game is called Guess the Penguin.
Here at WPOPR, our staff shows teamwork all of the time. Did you know our penguin staff has been on other teams in their lives? Let's play Guess the Penguin. Guess which one of our penguin staff is in each picture. Guess who this jockey is. Which one of our teachers had their head in the game on the basketball court. Guess who this tennis star is. Who is this multi-sport queen? Ian. Guess who kicked their way into our hearts as our assistant principal? I think you can tell who this is. Forget penguins. This penguin knows how to swim really fast on the swim team. Who is this cheerleader? Hirschfeld. But Ned, I bet you can guess who this teacher is. Cloud, he hasn't aged a day. Who is this queen of the softball field? Teacher specialist, Mrs. Godfrey. Who is this dancer? Who's Keiko? Another tap, tap, tapper. Bowser. Guess which one of our penguins was taken on the field? One of our penguins competitively figure skated in Switzerland. Kazal. He's got spirit. Yes, he does. Which one of our teachers is this? frogs.
You did an amazing job guessing some of our penguin staff. We'll have another round later, but let's hear more about our ELL celebration.
What's your name?
Ashlyn Lima-Gagmas.
And where were you born, Ashlyn?
Here, but my family are from Guatemala.
Have you ever been to Guatemala?
Yes.
What language do they speak in Guatemala?
Spanish.
What's the weather like in Guatemala?
Warm.
Or is it warm all the year?
Yes.
Do you ever need a jacket or a coat?
Nope.
You get to wear shorts all the time?
Yep.
What are some of your favorite foods from Guatemala?
Tamales, churrascos, tamales de elote, tortilla de harina, empanadas, tortillas.
What kind of things did you do for fun in Guatemala?
The Rio Dulce, it's ocean. I go somewhere that's called Zacapa, and I only know those.
Is it, what's Zacapa? Is it like a park or a place to play?
It's just somewhere to walk. There's a lot of stores.
Okay, kind of like a mall here.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Let's learn a little bit of Spanish together. Can you tell me how to count to 10 in Spanish?
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Chicharrón con pelos. Quiero yo chicharrón con
pelos. What's your name?
Gabriel.
Where were you born?
Here. From a family from Guatemala.
Have you ever traveled to Guatemala?
Yes.
Did you live in Guatemala?
Just for 2 months.
For 2 months. So like for vacations, for summer, okay? What's the weather like there?
Hot.
Really hot? Does it ever snow?
No.
Do you ever have to wear like a jacket or a sweatshirt?
Only when it's raining.
Only when it's raining. What kind of foods are from Guatemala?
Tamales, de pan, pelo de pan.
Well, what's your favorite?
Tamales.
And
tortilla de harina.
Oh, okay, some tortillas. Okay. What kind of things do people do for fun in Guatemala?
They go to Campo de Alegre, el Rio, they play football, Americano.
So what are those places? Is it like a park they go to?
In Campo de Alegre, where there's cows, you can run around, you can get some mangoes.
Ooh, sounds like a big farm, kind of.
You can put like salsas, lemon, lime.
And then they play football.
And there's an area where you play football.
Football, like how we throw the ball?
No. You play like soccer.
But you call it football?
Football Americano.
I know you can speak Spanish, right? That's the language in Guatemala. Can you tell me how to say school in Spanish?
Escuela.
Teacher?
Maestra.
How about pencil?
Lápiz.
Paper?
Papel.
How about computer?
Computadora.
Oh, so computer's kind of the same. Computadora,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Cool.
Do they speak in Guatemala?
It's Spanish.
What is the weather like in Guatemala?
It's like here, but it's not too cold there. Because here, they use a thing in the cars. It's called antifreeze. In Guatemala, they use water.
Okay. So you don't get snow or cold weather there?
No.
What are some favorite foods you had from Guatemala that might be different from here?
One is bache.
What is that?
It's like with potatoes, you smite them and you put everything.
What did you do for fun?
We play a game is called Tazos, and another game is Canicas, or we play Tenta, it's like that, and we play soccer.
Okay. Can you tell us any words in Spanish?
Run is correr, jump is saltar, and kids are niños.
Okay.
Gabriella, Ashlyn, and Justin. Now, let's take a pause before we hear some more celebrations. Let's hear from Mrs. Walker about Math Month and see if you can do a math magic trick.
Hello, William Pagel Old Post Road Penguins. Today we are going to celebrate Math Month with Mrs. Walker. We're going to celebrate today by doing a magic trick. Not the kind that you use cards for, and not the kind that you need to pull a rabbit out of a hat for. Today we are going to do a math magic trick. Are you ready? Good. To do this trick, we're going to need a clock face and our number lists. So you can see that we have all the words for our numbers 1 through 12 and our clock face. At the end of the trick, I will be able to guess whichever number you're pointing at on the clock. Are you ready? No matter which number you pick, I will be able to guess which number you land on. Let's see if I can do it. Now, the way to do this has to do with spelling out our number names. So I'm going to pretend that I'm following along with the trick, and I'm going to start with the number 2. So I know that the number 2 is spelled T-W-O. Those are 3 letters. I'm going to start on the number 12 and count those 3 letters, T-W-O, and land on the number 3. When I land on the number 3, my next move is to count out the letters that are in the number 3, starting on the number 4. T-H-R-E-E. Get the idea? We're going to do that 4 different times. Are you ready? I thought you were penguins. Let's go. Remember, we're going to use our clock face and our number lists to help us. I want you to think of a number, any of those numbers between 1 and 12 in the clock face. Do you have your number? Can you point to your number? Don't tell anyone, I don't want to hear you. Good. All right. Now remember, starting on the number 12, count the number of letters that are in your number word, starting on the number 1. Good. Now, whichever number you're on now, go to the next number and start counting out the numbers that are in the letters that are in that number's name. Are you on your next number? Good. Same thing. Whichever number you landed on, go to the next number and start counting out the number of letters that were in the number's name that you landed on. All right, let's see how we're doing, penguins. Right now, I know that there is no one that is on the number 2. I also know that there is no one that is on the number 4. We can take that off our list too. I know that there's no one that's on the number 8, and that there's no one on the number 12. All right, so now our clock looks a little funny. It's missing some numbers, but that's okay. The next time that we count our numbers, just ignore those blank spaces and just count the numbers that we have left. So now you should be on a number, and I want you to say that number's name, and I want you to count the number of letters that are in that number's name and stop. Well, I can tell that you weren't on the number 1. And I know that you weren't on the number 5. In fact, I know that you were not on numbers 3, 7, 9, or 11. Did you land on the number 6? Was 6 your number? Remember, penguins, it's not magic, it's math magic. Happy April Math Month.
Thank you, Mrs. Walker, for that math magic. We are celebrating math this entire month. We're also celebrating our ELL month. We have 2 more student celebrations for you from Karina and from Godsent. Take it away, my friends.
Me and my family are from Mexico.
What's the weather like in Mexico?
Hot.
What language do they speak in Mexico?
Spanish.
So you can speak Spanish and English, right? Mm-hmm. Can you tell me some words in Spanish?
Mm-hmm. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
What does hola mean?
Hola means, in English, means hello.
What does ¿cómo estás mean?
¿Cómo estás means in English?
How do you say goodbye in Spanish?
it's adiós.
How could I say thank you?
Thank you, you say it in Spanish, gracias.
And how about you're welcome?
Welcome, you say it in Spanish, de nada.
What kind of foods do you like from Mexico? What did you eat?
So in Mexico we drink a soda. So for the first time I drink soda instead of bag. Tamales, my mom always makes it at home. Tortillas, quesadillas, churros, pan y carne.
I'm God Sims, and my last name is EKJ4, and I'm from Nigeria.
What's the weather like in Nigeria?
In my mom's region, the weather is usually sunny, but for like some days it's kind of rainy. In my dad's region, it's kind of always rainy, but sometimes it's really hot.
Is it hotter than the United States overall?
Yes.
What language or languages do they speak in Nigeria?
So my mom speaks Igbo and my dad speaks Iker.
Can you say anything in either language?
Well, yeah. I can say a lot in Igbo, but my dad, but when I was in Africa, I used to like know them very well. So my mom, I can speak Igbo, like Kiroti Day is like, how are you? What did you eat is like, kiri-hiri.
Speaking of eat, tell me about the foods that you remember from Nigeria. What were your favorites?
My favorite food was chim chim is a snack. It's made out of dough. You make it like a usual cake, but it's not a cake. So you fry it, and then it would be kind of hard, but like it's really sweet. And akamu is like, it's for everyone, especially babies. It's really soft. You can put anything you want, like chocolate or vanilla and stuff. It's really good. And plantain and fried rice is like, in my country, it's like an everyday food because after a long day of work, everybody likes to eat that. We do a lot of stuff in Nigeria for fun, like to climb trees. What else that we do for fun is that we use like a tire of some sort, and then we use a stick and then roll it. Or sometimes when, this is a treat that my dad gives me and my mom. Whenever we come back from America, my dad takes us to this place. It's like an arcade. We have food. And then there's one place that my dad took me. It's like virtual reality. And then it's on a roller coaster. So that's what me and my family do for fun and other of my friends.
Thank you, Karina and Godsent. Now, we are celebrating teamwork this month, and our friends really worked hard as a team to get this power up ready for you. Speaking of teams, our PE department, who's a team, has a fitness workout for you. Stand on up and let's go. Our fabulous Pika PE teachers have prepared a Would You Rather fitness for us. On each slide, there's two different options. You choose which one you would rather do and do that exercise. Let's get ready. Would you rather have to listen to the same song every day for a week or listen to the same five songs every day for a month. Would you rather eat ice cream or a snowball? Great workout, and I love that it featured some of our PECA teachers. Now, we are going to learn about teamwork from our PECA counselor, Mrs. Felty.
Good morning, Penguin friends, and welcome to our presentation about teamwork. We can do this. What does teamwork look like? Well, take a look at these two pictures. Strings wrapped together. Notice how each of the strings wraps to the other, and it makes a very strong rope. All of us together working can create a very strong and powerful presentation or activity or win a game. The other picture, puzzle pieces fitting together, takes all those pieces together, all of you who are part of our puzzle here this year, to work together to make it such a fantastic school environment. So glad that all of you are part of those pieces. The word team can be broken down into an acronym. Each letter of the word stands for another word. T, together. E, everyone. A, achieves. M, more. Together, everyone achieves more. That's our teamwork. What helps make teamwork all the better? Well, whenever you have group work to do, you work together as a team. It doesn't matter whether you're just partnered with one person or if there's five people in your group. Each of you needs to work together. Figure out what it is that you need to complete. Look at the directions, read them all the way through before you begin. Have each person say what they are good at doing and have them work on that part. Maybe you're really good at writing words out on big poster board, or maybe you're really good at drawing, or maybe you're good at looking up things on the computer through Google. Whatever it is, that's the part that you should be working on. Then each person does their job until everyone is finished and we have a final project that we can all look at together and critique to decide, do we have everything we need? Then we're ready to hand it in and we have done our best work. Want to be a good teammate? There's some important things you need to do. First of all, you need to be a really good listener. You need to listen to what the coach is telling you to do and then do what they say so that your team might be the winner that day. Communicate. Do you ever watch a soccer game and hear them yelling out to each other to pass the ball? That's part of communicate. Also, maybe you're struggling with something and so you say to another player, hey, I'm really having trouble with this. Could you give me a hand with that and help me to get better at it? That's communicating. Share your ideas. Maybe you see something going on that you think we need to change. Then you need to bring it up. But you need to bring it up politely and not be making fun of anybody while you're doing it. Then your team will be a team. Remember, every person has a talent. Maybe yours is reading. Maybe yours is math. Maybe yours is sports. Maybe yours is art. Maybe yours is music. We all have a talent. And we need to listen to one another and share ideas. Be surprised what you might learn if you actually sat down and talked with someone and listened to what their ideas were also. Working together as a team makes work easier and faster because there's less arguing and more teamwork. I hope that you will be a great team player.
Thank you, Mrs. Felty. We have loved learning about and celebrating teamwork today with our ELL month, with math month, and with celebrating our penguins who show their pride every single day. To finish up our assembly, let's play one more round of Guess the Penguin. Let's see if you can guess some of our penguin staff members from their young team photos.
Who is this sweet cheerleader? Yambaluka! Check out this field hockey star! Miss Johnson! Let's go Bobcats! Who is this cheerleader?
Welcome to the big show!
This is Hamill! Serve strong, dig fierce, spike hard. Guess who this volleyball player is? Mare. And who is this spotted dance star? I wonder if you can guess who this cheerleader is. What a great catch from this penguin who caught all of our hearts. Who could it be? It's Mrs. Amato. Teamwork makes the dream work. Who is this member of a troop? Miss Diamond. I bet you can guess who this field hockey star is. Mrs. Reynolds. Who
was this dancer that danced her way into our hearts? Richie, put me in, coach. Check out this baseball star. Who could this cutie be? It's Walker. Here she is with a hole in one and number one in our hearts. It's Miss Shiflet. And last but not least, can you guess who this penguin is? Ready to hit a home run. Other than Mr. Stump. Great job, friends.
All right, penguins. We hope that you have enjoyed this teamwork power-up assembly. Next month, we will be celebrating our school family, our Ohana, with a tropical-themed celebration. We can't wait to see you, penguins, and continue celebrating our penguin pride.